looking up in the stand at Moshe Hugh and the Egyptian fans. Let me add to that. The Egyptian fans, the Egyptian team, the Egyptian coach, all in celebration. They're in a huddle, up in the stand, there they are. I think they won. In fact, I'm sure they won. Now they turn and face the pitch, where Finland and Russia are next up. After this match, hopefully, we might have the company of Jason Mohammed. Give me a hand in the commentary. Russia just looking, well, to work that, and they worked it well, and they a goal to the good. It's surprising how often that move is used and how little it's defended against. It's not easy, because if the keeper does come out to cut out the cross, then he's caught on his near post. And always a defender short if the wide men work it. Up to the defenders. Oh, well, that's just given away and given back. Chance for a second. Could have been a bit more selfish than that, but decides not to be. And this time he misses his chance. Again, Russia dominating the ball and scoring. A lovely little finish. Clever little finish, 2-0. It's not all about power. Finland trying to get on the break. Can't make the most of it and almost get caught out. Should have been caught out with that long through ball. Good start by Russia, but good starts can disappear fairly quickly in this competition. Little dummy, then a pull back. Really been an effort to the far corner, but it wasn't. And now Russia have to get back. Well won back. Very well done. Good piece of play. Already beaten twice, the Finnish keeper. And he's beaten for the third time. According to figures, 3% of Russia's population are homeless, which doesn't sound a lot, but it is a well-populated country. And it's good to see these competitors enjoying themselves. I walked in with a lot of them this morning, and they were all smiles, and enjoying their visit to Cardiff, and enjoying the World Cup as well. Few were thankful that they didn't have more than one or two games during the day. Won't mention the Welsh women. They've started with a win and a defeat. A win against Northern Ireland and a defeat against England. This is Russia leading 3-0 against Finland. So far, the countries that have impressed have been the South American countries, certainly. and South Africa. So Russia scored a fourth. Brazil look particularly good. Brazil, incidentally, are the only side that I've seen so far that have a female competitor in the mixed team, because this is a, they say it's a men's competition, but it's actually a mixed competition. So men and women can play in this competition, only women in the other one. If you get my drift. But Brazil have used two or three female players, two or three good female players, the best female player in the world came from Brazil, Mata. Add that to the best football male player in Pelé. See the strength and the tradition of Brazil, and no surprise that they brought a strong side to Cardiff this year. Russia get a fifth. Strong is the adjective you'd use for Russia as well. Almost a touch of deftness about that as well. Yeah, six. Good play at the edge of the penalty area. Over enthusiastic, just stepping into the orange zone. Finland have possession. Still a minute to go till half time. They're already 6-0. See some high scores. Hungary got to 12. Egypt and Bosnia shared a dozen goals and two blue cards. And then Russia got seven. And we're not up to 7 minutes yet. That's high, wide, and not so handsome. An acrobatic save stops Finland taking the lead. What's the decision? Is he outside his area? Yeah, he was outside his area. Then there's going to be a penalty to Finland. Oof. I mean, that was hit like a rocket, but it missed. I think the keeper was lucky not to be in the way of that one. So a missed penalty by Finland. The Russian keeper stepping outside his area. And it's 7-0 at half time. And boy, do they look comfortable. Be tied legs in the Finnish team in the second half. Just the Russian keeper just checking that what the offence was, and it's just been confirmed that he's outside his area, so that was a penalty. A penalty that was missed. These are the players that have done the damage so far, and this is how. Again, the pass across the orange zone. Finds the spare player, and that was a lovely finish. Really, really deft finish. So many of them will just power them in. It's nice to see a little flick every now and then. They're out for the second half.
Russia against Finland.
So we just see the tail end of the highlights.
Game on.
And it is a mountain to climb for Finland now. Well, particularly as Russia's just scored an eighth. Less than 8 seconds gone, and there's an eighth goal gone in. Finland desperately trying to work something just to get on the score sheet. Went near post, could have gone far. Punishment, the free kick given for an overarm throw by the goalkeeper. There's a restart in the middle. Russia can just take their time. Had another one there, 9. Finland trying to get down into the corner, just get as far away from their own goal as possible. It's another good stop. He's a fairly tall goalkeeper and he gets down well. Well worked. Double figures are up. Gives me a chance to remind you of Facebook and all the inspiring stories that are on there from the Homeless World Cup, and there are new stories every day. So if you want to have a look at those, well, visit facebook.com/homelessworldcup. Quite inspiring for Finland if they could just get a goal. Missed a penalty just before half time. Russia just moving them about at the moment, and that should be an 11 for this. Now we haven't got to 10 minutes yet. It's a bit frightening. We might have one of the highest scores so far. No, that's too cheeky. Although, did the keeper step outside? Yeah, I think this keeper stepped outside his orange area, so it's going to be a penalty to Russia. So this could be 12 before we reach the 10-minute mark. Two touches. No, he's not allowed to do that. He's going to shoot. He decided he was going to dribble it, so it's not going to count. So sometimes the laws can be a bit baffling. But at that time, at least we've got a referee to help us. Russia still looking for their 12th goal. Finland searching for their first. And we have got 4.5 minutes remaining of this game. Just happy to keep passing the ball. There is the 12th. It's never ever going to be long in coming. So they have got about, well, 3 and a bit minutes to increase their goal tally. And well, that's the first headed attempt we've had on target. Almost successful. Russia on the break once more. 11 and a half minutes gone, 12-0 up. Life's good for them in the Welsh capital. Again, they try and head it in, and again, it hasn't worked. Just feel they're gilding the lily a little bit. Effort on target by Finland, but that's intercepted, and that's another chance missed. That's about 3 or 4 chances they've missed in the last minute and a half. Twelve minutes gone, 12-0 up. Can this be 13? Yeah. Let's see why not. 13. Finland desperate for that whistle to go now. Russia quite happy to keep playing. Keep piling on the agony. Finland just trying to hang on to the ball. Just for a couple of seconds, just a waste of a few seconds as we go into the last minute. stick it down there, out the way. Back it comes though, that's the problem. Is there another goal in the last minute? Can they take it to 14? And then average the goal a minute. Team that bothered. A pinball in there at the moment. That didn't quite cross the line. The referee was had a good angle on it. Just watch the clock tick by into the last 10 seconds. Decisive win for Russia. Could have been even more decisive, of course. But it didn't need to be. Full-time goals. Comfortable win for Russia, 12-0. And they'll get another 3 points and climb the group table once more. It's 13-0, that's the final score. No goals for Finland, they did miss a penalty. As both sets of players gather either side of the halfway line. Spirit of sportsmanship, good effort by Finland. But totally outclassed by the Russian outfit, I'm afraid. I don't think there are any Finland highlights in this. Most of them will be Russian, for obvious reasons. That's the best goal of the lot. Certainly one of the best goals we've seen in the tournament so far.
Just before we get on with the football on pitch one, there's another match coming up straight away now. Open the bet on tent. There is a debate. Homelessness and the city. Well,